India is well known around the world owing to its historical background, diverse cultures, and interesting traditions. Its ancient scriptures and texts have been the way of life of its people for thousands of years. Today, the country is taking huge strides in the field of science and technology, paving a way towards a progressive India. So friends, I am your host Sonika Mendiratta, and today in our episode of My India, we will take a look at some of the stories that very well showcase the unique culture and prosperity of our country, stretching from Himalayas to Kanyakumari. The Indian subcontinent has always been a treasury of talent, be it in the field of art, science, literature, or anything else. However, Indian art forms have gained special prominence as India is famous for being the home to a large number of exceptionally brilliant artists and unique art forms, which is clear from the recently held Himachal Art Festival.
The art of painting in India dates back to the ancient times, as is evident from the cave paintings of Ajanta and Ellora. To carry forward this legacy, several platforms have been provided to Indian artists from time to time to showcase their talent. Himachal Art Festival is one such initiative that invites artists from different parts of the country under one roof. Held in the northern hill town of Shimla this year, around 100 artists took part in the four-day festival that was organized by the Language and Culture Department of Himachal State Museum.
ये जो फेस्टिवल है, ये हिमाचल प्रदेश में कला गतिविधियों को बढ़ावा देने के लिए किया गया है, क्योंकि शिमला राजधानी के तौर पर ब्रिटिश पीरियड्स में यहाँ बहुत नामी गिरामी कलाकारों ने काम किया है उसके बाद भी यहाँ शिमला से संबंध रखने वाले अंतर्राष्ट्रीय स्तर के बहुत से कलाकार रहे हैं जिनमें राम कुमार जी है कृष्ण खन्ना है डी के चोपड़ा है और अमृता शेरगिल ने यहाँ पे काम किया है तो इस तरह से कि यहाँ के जो स्थानीय लोग हैं उनको कला के प्रति जागरूक करने के लिए और यहाँ के जो लोकल कलाकार है उनको प्लेटफॉर्म देने के लिए कि वो भी सीनियर आर्टिस्टों के साथ काम करे और उनमें एक कॉन्फिडेंस बिल्ड हो कि वो भी इस फील्ड में आगे बढ़ सकते हैं
Along with Indian artists, a number of international participants like that from Uganda and England were also part of the event. From making the beautiful paintings of Buddha to transforming the whole landscape on a sheet, the artists left the visitors awestruck with their brilliant imagination. The festival also served as a great learning experience for the budding artist who got to interact with some renowned personalities belonging to the same field.
फेस्टिवल है यहाँ पे इंटरनेशनल और स्टेट से बहुत सारे आर्टिस्ट आए हुए जिन्हें देख के हमें कुछ सीखने को मिल रहा है यहाँ पे सबकी पेंटिंग्स बहुत अच्छी है और हम लोग यहाँ पे पेंटिंग्स करके बहुत इंजॉय कर रहे हैं
एक प्लेटफॉर्म पे स्कूल और डिग्री कॉलेज के विद्यार्थी भी काम कर रहे हैं और बहुत से डिस्कशन भी हो रहे हैं साथ साथ में उनको पूरे इंडिया के आर्ट को देखने को एक मौका मिल रहा है हर आर्टिस्ट का स्टाइल अलग है सब्जेक्ट मैटर अलग है तो शायद वो कोई दिल्ली ना जा सके कोई मुंबई ना जा सके कोई हैदराबाद तो एक सारे जगहों से जब आर्टिस्ट नहीं आए हुए हैं तो विद्यार्थियों को लाभ मिल रहा है और लाभान्वित भी हो रहे हैं विद्यार्थी
The festival is a great initiative towards protecting, preserving and promoting the several Indian art forms and providing a proper platform to the existing as well as upcoming artists for displaying their creation.
This dargah is for everyone. Hindus, Muslims, Christians, whoever comes here gets his wishes fulfilled. Dargah Sharif of Siddhi Bhasha, situated in the Kalaburgi district of Karnataka, is thronged by devotees belonging to varied religions, castes, creeds, and ethnicities. Over the years, dargah has remained an epitome of religious coexistence and mutual tolerance among the people of southern India. Take a look.
Away from hustle and bustle of the cities where fast-track life doesn't allow one to take a sigh of relief, Dargah Sharif or Siddhi Bhasha has a large compound to hold number of devotees. Situated in the Kalaburgi district, devotees cutting across religious line throng the shrine to seek the blessing of the holy saint Siddhi Bhasha. Hindu considers it as a temple and Muslim as the abode of Allah. It is believed that seeking blessings from Saint Siddhibasha fulfills all the desires of the devotees who come to the Durga from different corners of the country.
Hindu, Muslims aur sab jat ke idhar pira karte hain. Abhi se nahi, chand saalon se yahan pe pira karte hain. Sabko acha hua hai aur main bhi Siddhibasha ka bhakt hu. Mere ko bhi acha hua hai. Kayo yahan se karodpati ban gaye hain, kayo leaders bane hain. Acha acha yahan pe hue hain. ये क्या हिंदू मुस्लिम ऐसा मुस्लिम्स का बोल के नहीं है सिद्धिभाषा सबका है सब जात का हिंदू मुस्लिम सब लोग जात आते हैं यहाँ पे सब उनका दिल का जो मुराद है सिद्धिभाषा करते हैं सबका
Decorated with freshly laid colorful flowers and holy chadars, the shrine of the Sufi saint is wished upon by a number of devotees who come at the doors of this highly recognized darga. The silver railings along the main shrine of Saint Siddhibasha are filled with red threads fastened on it. The fastening of threads is a popular way among its devotees to put their wishes across to their revered saint. The graceful saint is believed to take care of all these wishes and turn them into reality for his faithful devotees.
Here, Hindu, Muslim, all are one. And inshallah, someone comes, then the murad is packed. The government has it. सरकार का ये कर्म है अल्लाह के फजल से बहुत सारे नियाज होते हैं और जो है यहाँ नज़र होते हैं और जो खवाली वाले आते हैं और जो पब्लिक बहुत आते हैं
The Durga holds great significance. The Muslims and Hindus alike equally revere their saint for his lifelong practice of bringing all the religions, castes, creeds and communities under one roof of unity.
And now a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently. Muslims across India observed Shab-e-Barat, a holy festival where they seek the blessings of the Almighty, pray for the departed souls of their ancestors and seek forgiveness for their sins. Shab-e-Barat means night of salvation or night of acquittal and as per Islamic rules, this is the day of divine benediction when devotees offer prayers and fast for the departed souls of their loved ones, a ritual known as Fateha. In Nadan Muradabad city, Muslims cleaned up the graveyards and decorated it with lights and candles for performing rituals during the night.
Aaj hamare Shab-e-Qadr ki raat hai. Aaj hum log Allah ke isme hum log namaz-e-nafil wagaira ada karte hain, sunnatein ada karte hain, apne rishtedar, ajidar, walid mohtaram सबों की कब्र पे जाके अपने लिए सबों के लिए दुआ करते हैं कि अल्लाह रब्बुल इज्जत हम लोगों के ख़ानदान में जो भी जहां जैसे कि उनके लिए अल्लाह उन्हें आला से आला मकाम अता फरमाए
इन इंडियन कैपिटल न्यू दिल्ली सिक्योरिटी वाज बीफ्ड अप फॉर द फेस्टिवल व्हिच सीज अ लॉट ऑफ डेवोटीज कम आउट ऑन द स्ट्रीट्स फॉर प्रेयर्स द डे इज डीम्ड एज एन इनोवेशन टू द फेथ बाय मोस्ट स्कॉलर्स सम इवन कंसीडर इट एज अ सिन The final leg of third edition of the National Blind Football Tournament recently concluded with flying colours in India's southern Kochi city of Kerala. The home team won the game and with it the sparkling trophy too. The tournament, which started 4 days ago, was organised by Indian Blind Football Federation, an independent federation set up in 2016 affiliated to the Paralympic Committee of India and IBSA New Delhi with an aim to promote sports in the blind people's community.
What we aim to do through this is create awareness so that more teams come forward, they take up the game in a bigger way so that the blind, as they sit wherever they are, we want to encourage them to play football, any sport for the matter.
The outfield players in this version of the game are completely blind and wear eye shades to ensure their completely blocked vision. However, the goalkeeper may be partially sighted too. There are no throw-ins and offside rules in this form of sport and the field has a rebound wall. The spectators too sit quietly to ensure that the players can hear the ball. Popular faces from the Indian film industry dazzled the Dada Saheb Phalke Awards red carpet in Mumbai. Bollywood actor Shahid Kapoor won the Best Actor Award at the Dada Saheb Phalke Excellence Awards 2018 for his performance in controversial period drama Padmavat. Bollywood actress Aditi Rao Hydri was also awarded for her performance in a film that revolves around rape.
ये पहला अवार्ड है इस साल का जो पद्मावत की तरफ मुझे मिल रहा है, तो मैं बहुत खुश हूँ। बहुत ही इम्पॉर्टेंट फिल्म रही है मेरे करियर में, और ये अवार्ड मैं अपनी बीवी को डेडिकेट करना चाहता हूँ, क्योंकि अगर उन्होंने मुझे एक साल झेला नहीं होता तो मैं ये फिल्म नहीं कर पाता। सो आई एम वेरी थैंकफुल टू हर, एंड ऑफ कोर्स इट्स अ वेरी प्रेस्टिजियस अवार्ड। आई एम वेरी हैप्पी टू बी हियर टू रिसीव इट फॉर द एंटायर टीम ऑफ पद्मावत, एंड यस, आई एम वेरी एक्साइटेड।
Bollywood actor Manish Paul bagged the award for Best Television Entertainer, while the bygone beauty actress Manisha Koirala bagged the honor for Most Versatile Actress. Actress filmmaker Konkana Sen Sharma also bagged the trophy for Best Debutant Director for critically acclaimed thriller A Death in the Ganj. Other than this, playback singers Arman Malik and Neeti Mohan also got the award for Best Playback Singer, Male and Female respectively.
मैं बहुत ही खुश हूँ कि मुझे 2014 में मेरे डेब्यू में मिला था मैं हुई रो तेरा में, और फिर मुझे आज मिला है, so thank you to everyone.
The Dada Saheb Phalke Award is the highest award of Indian cinema. It is presented annually by an organization set up by the Indian Broadcasting Ministry since 1969 to recognize the contribution of film personalities towards the development of Indian cinema. An annual interstate angling competition was recently held near India's northeastern Dimapur city to promote the sport among locals. A regional angling organization, Musu Angling Center, organized the event where more than 150 anglers from neighboring states of Assam, Nagaland and West Bengal took part.
Nagaland as a whole, you know, we have very broad scope for angling. We have anglers from different age group, from different walks of society, old, young, rich, poor, government officials, business people. So, and even women also, we have female anglers as well. So this is very encouraging, and it is picking up at a great pace.
Angling is slowly but steadily picking up pace in the northeastern state. Though not as popular a pastime as it is in the west, angling has its loyal followers in India and is also a growing sport in various states. Today in our section of Asia Buzz, we will see how Japan's innovative technology is making life easier for the people. The companies are constantly doing research on how to develop new products and services that can facilitate its users. We have a report.
Ibara Corporation is a Japanese industrial equipment manufacturer with over 100 years of history producing machinery, including water pumps. The company has also introduced a water pump with advanced technology and near-field communication function. At its plant in Fujisawa, Ibara Corporation produces pumps which are used in various places such as condominiums, office buildings and factories in Japan as well as abroad. Visitors can have a look at the exhibition corner and see that Ibara has production bases in many different countries. With such a long history, Ibara continues to introduce new pumps using advanced technology.
ビル、マンション向けの給水ポンプというのは長く販売してくれましたけれども、やっぱりですね、ニーズとしてあったのが、やっぱり使いやすい、扱いやすい製品というところで、給水を担う製品ですので、止まってしまうと非常に迷惑がかかってしまうというところもありますので、早く復旧させるためにはですね、日々の点検をしていただきたいと。
Near field communication, NFC, is a short range wireless technology that enables communication between devices in distance of less than 10 cm. At Ibara Corporation office, systems equipped with NFC functions can be seen in various places such as office stores and the staff canteens. NFC system has very familiar presence surrounding the office environment. Ibara also puts great efforts in introducing the NFC system for the products and has announced the production of water supply pump with NFC system for the market.
事前にですね、専用のアプリをスマートフォンの方にインストールして、このスマートフォンをですね、この操作表示部にタッチするだけで運転状態をですね、表示できる機能を追加しました。これによってですね、従来操作表示部を触らなければいけなかったんですけれども、スマートフォンを使って運転状態を簡単に把握することができます。
取得した情報はですね、メールなどを使って送信することができますので、正確な情報を把握することができ、効率的な点検やメンテナンスを行うことができます。
This latest water supply pump with NFC functions will be introduced for not only Japanese domestic market but also overseas, and it is expected that more convenient functions will be delivered worldwide in the near future. The long-term development efforts and the history of technology in Japan contribute to improvement of lives in countries around the world. Next, we will see how GCP is improving its services for foreign visitors. The former capital of Japan, Kyoto is famous worldwide for its ancient cityscape and unique scenery. This city attracts millions of tourists from abroad annually. This time, Japan's only international credit payment brand, GCP has special promotions that are limited to foreign guests who have a membership. These services include introducing various sightseeing spots in Kyoto to enrich members' experience during their stay. GCP Plaza Kyoto, located inside JR Kyoto Station Building, offers various services for its international members.
GCP Plaza は現地情報に精通したスタッフが観光情報や優待店情報の提供、ホテルやレストラン、オプショナルツアーの手配を行う JCB 会員専用のサービス窓口です。国内外の主要観光都市を中心に設置しております。日本国内では海外の JCB 会員様向けに東京、京都に設置しております。
For GCP international members, GCP Plaza Kyoto offers various services which make traveling around Kyoto more reasonable and satisfactory. Kyoto Tower, a rare modern and iconic landmark, is the tallest structure in Kyoto City. This remarkable spot is one of the most worthy places to visit for members of GCP. Gensai Tourist Information Center inside Kyoto Tower is giving a lot of information about tourism and helping tourists not only to find different attractions but also manage luggage services. It also has discount promotion for popular tourist rail passes for Gensai area that GCP foreign members can get benefit. The reason why many people look forward to visiting Kyoto Tower is going up to the observation deck. GCP members get 30% discount on admission fees, which make access to the observation deck very reasonable. It is located 100 meters above ground with a viewing platform providing a 360-degree view of Kyoto. Here, people can really enjoy many kinds of scenes of Kyoto City. GCP Plaza Kyoto is not only introducing sightseeing spots, but also providing comfortable environments inside its space. This place is also used as a lounge exclusively for international members of JCB and also provides PCs, printers, tour guide books and luggage services, etc.
こちら JCB プラザ京都ではフレンドリーで親切なスタッフが英語や中国語対応で旅のお手伝いをさせていただいております。アクセスが良い JR 京都駅のビル内にあり、京都らしく静かでくつろげる空間でのご休憩や JCB カード利用での抽選キャンペーン、当日中の手荷物預かり無料サービスなど大変便利にご利用いただいております。
The special efforts of Japan for hospitality and treatment for international visitors continue to attract tourists and contribute to culture exchange worldwide.
In the multicultural society of India, mass marriages are setting in a vogue these days. Coming from different sections of society, 400 couples tied the nuptial knot in a grand mass wedding ceremony in Kanpur city of Uttar Pradesh, showcasing the unification of this widely diversified nation. Take a look. Amidst the ritualistic chants, grooms donning suits and the traditional headdress were all set to take oaths with their partners for a lifetime. Brides and grooms later exchanged garlands and performed all wedding rituals in the presence of their families. Organized by the Labor Department of Uttar Pradesh State on the occasion of International Labor Day, the newlywed couples were also given a sum of around 65,000 rupees by the state government, providing a happy start to their new life.
बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है यहाँ पे. यहाँ अच्छा लगने से आगे की जो है हर साल आने वाली में इससे भी ज्यादा जनता बढ़ने की संभावना हो जाएगी.
Around 400 couples coming from different religions, communities and social strata tied the nuptial knots at a mass wedding ceremony held in the northern city of Kanpur.
इसमें हिंदू मुस्लिम दोनों जोड़ों का विवाह हो रहा है। ₹65,000 इनके खाते में RTGS के माध्यम से भेजा जाएगा।
Mass weddings are increasingly becoming popular, especially among the economically weaker sections of the Indian society, as they reduce the financial burden on the couple and their families. Mass weddings not just help weaker section in their marriages, but a platform to promote oneness and harmony among myriad castes, creeds and faiths residing in our country. The motorcycle ambulance that has saved lives of hundreds in the areas of Chhattisgarh, Hyderabad and Bengaluru is all set to ply the busy roads and narrow lanes of the Mumbai city. So, let's take a look at this free bike ambulance service that was recently launched in Mumbai to provide swift medical assistance to patients.
The Mumbai city is all set to deal with the medical emergency amidst high traffic with its launch of 24/7 bike ambulance services. Equipped with first aid kit, oxygen cylinder and stretcher, the ambulance has all the facilities that a normal ambulance has, along with the provision of a space for doctors to sit at the back. Introduced by Lodha Foundation, a Mumbai-based charitable trust, the main aim to start this bike ambulance was to carry patients to hospitals free of cost in order to make them cover long distances in short period of time during the golden hour.
जी हमारा सबसे पहला एम ये है कि बिना एक पैसे का खर्चा दिए हुए वो पेशेंट को हॉस्पिटल में जल्दी से जल्दी कैसे हम लोग पहुँचा सके. आजकल एम्बुलेंस का खर्चा ही इतना है कि पेशेंट को वो खर्चा जुटाने में ही टाइम चला जाता है. उससे अच्छा वो फ़ोन कर सकता है, तुरंत हमारी जो मोबाइल जो है ये बाइक एम्बुलेंस वो आ जाएगी और उसको फटाफट हॉस्पिटल पहुंचा देंगे. उसको कुछ भी टेंशन की ज़रूरत नहीं है कि मेरे पास पैसा नहीं है. सबसे पहली वो हमारा एम है कि हमारा जो मलबार हिल विधानसभा है वहाँ पे बिना मूल्य ये सब हम लोगों को फ्री ऑफ कॉस्ट सर्विस देनी है.
Currently, only one bike ambulance is launched, but with the demand, more such ambulances will be introduced. It is available through 108 free helpline and has teams of paramedics providing treatment. The service is unique in its approach, as sometimes four-wheeler ambulances get stuck in traffic or cannot travel through the narrow lanes.
ऐसे कई इलाके हैं जहाँ पे बड़ी एम्बुलेंस जा नहीं सकती है और पेशेंट को स्ट्रेचर पे बाहर लेके आना पड़ता है. तो हमने ये सब ने मिलकर सोचा और ये एम्बुलेंस बनवा के लिए ये एम्बुलेंस छोटी छोटी गलियों में भी जा सकती है और इसमें वो सारी सुविधा हैं जो कि एक बड़ी एम्बुलेंस में होती है. ऑक्सीजन सिलेंडर है, पेशेंट को सुलाने का है, जरूरत पड़े तो पीछे डॉक्टर भी साथ में बैठ सकता है, एमरजेंसी मेडिकल किट है.
Such ambulances are not a new concept in India. It has proved to be a boon for patients, especially accident victims in several areas of Chhattisgarh, Karnataka and many other states. And now it's Mumbai city which is going to reap the benefits of the bike ambulance.
And that's all we have for this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at suggest.myindia@gmail.com. I'm your host, Sonika Mendiratta, and it's a goodbye from the entire production team.